Hey everyone, this is Mo Dian here, designer and creator of these do-it-yourself Pelican Bluetooth hard case boomboxes. So this is one of my latest creations. I've built several of these with the Pelican 1200. I think this is the fifth one at least, maybe version 4. But this one's pretty unique because this will be the first one that has the DSP WONDOM amps with the ADAU1701 chipset, which is totally programmable, so you can really custom tweak and tune everything on this guy here. This is a 2.1 system. In this case here, I'm using Tang Band components, 2-inch full range aluminum drivers, the two that you see right there. Typically in the past, I've used a mid-range and a tweeter, but I wanted to make this one a little bit more simple because simply it's a smaller box. And then using the 3.5-inch RBM subwoofer, also made by Tang Band. And so that's the 2.1, 50 watts per channel on the 2-inch Tang Band drivers. And the cutoff frequency crossover is right around 300 hertz for this setup here. I'm using a Linkwitz Riley 48 dB per octave through SigmaStudio with the programming, and paired up with a 3.5-inch subwoofer. It does go down to right around 40 hertz with no issues there. Nice and clean and really low and gutsy. On the back is the 3.5-inch Peerless passive woofer on the back that's not being driven. Starting on the back side, I have a 6-pin AV custom-made communication feed-through that I can use SigmaStudio via in-circuit programmer made by WONDOM, and this goes directly to the JAB 3, which is the 100-watt mono amp that has the integrated DSP chip on it. And then there's a charging port on the back, and of course I'm using this passive, totally passive, not a BBE preamp, but this is a completely passive, I think a $3 eBay volume treble bass controller. It seems to work pretty well, but I lose a lot of signal. So I have to go into DSP and actually adjust the gain to back up. There's a red power switch button, controls everything. And then we have a blue LED for the Bluetooth, and then a red for the power of the whole unit here. And then on the front, we have this really cheap $3, $4 battery capacity voltage meter. It works really great. You can set it up for just about any type of battery type, lithium, lead acid battery, whatever. I have it set up for lithium. It's configured in 5S21 volts. There's a button here. It shows, let's see, press it again, right around 20 volts. It's almost fully charged. And then the button also goes to off, but I leave it on. So whenever I turn it off, everything comes on. Bluetooth is not on either. Everything's completely powered off, turn it on. Comes up with the battery voltage and red blinking light, and then blue solid means it's connected to my already. So let's go inside, look at some of the details on the inside. Just open this guy up. And so I designed, this one's a really, really tight fit overall. I'd say this is a moderate to more difficult challenge. The hardest one is that little 1030 Bose sound leak mini that I did maybe a few years ago. That one's really challenging. This one's a little bit not as challenging, but you have more space. But some things to keep in mind, some things I really had to think about the design because I wanted the full range 2-inch drivers to be completely enclosed and sealed, and they are right now. So I'm using, I don't know, it looks like maybe 2 or 3 inch PVC piping with glue, and it's completely sealed, airtight. So they have their own closure, and then the subwoofer uses everything else, which is obviously sealed tight when the lid is closed, and works in conjunction with the passive subwoofer in the back there. Okay, so we have, let me just start with the battery bank. It's a 5S configuration, 2P, two banks in parallel. I made a video on how to make this guy, so just look that one up. I'm using a really cheap eBay maintenance board. That's the green board in the back. Just type in 5S lithium protection drill, So this is good for like up to 10 or 15 amps. It's designed for like electric motors or high current devices, like a, you know, hand drill or something like that. So this guy works pretty well. I have a fuse on there. So really the only loads are, you have the 2 amp boards. The one on the left is the Jab 2 50 watt per channel board, and then the Jab 3, which is a 100 watt per channel board, and this battery meter. That's really the only three loads that take 21 volts, all controlled by just a simple push button switch there. Some of the key differences here is, now instead of saying Shure as the Bluetooth ID, it says WONDOM. So I think these must be the latest versions, because I've used something very similar, but maybe slightly older generation. But one key difference here is, you can see that this WONDOM 50 watt per channel Jab 2 has this thing called AirGain. So apparently there's this, an external tiny little antenna that connects to the Bluetooth chip. I don't know if you can see it, but it's buried all in the back left. I know in the past I've just used like a 4-inch solid copper wire soldered to the Bluetooth antenna to increase the range, because in the past these Bluetooth boards have had really, they're supposed to be like 10 meters for a range, but in reality they're more like 10 feet. So my little hack in the past of soldering a 4-inch solid copper wire seemed to really do the trick, and really extended out to about 60 to 70 feet, which is almost double the Bluetooth standard. But with this AirGain, I haven't had any issues, haven't really tested it with, in terms of where it starts to fall off, but apparently it's more than 10 feet. Other than that, there's some other small bugs when you connect. In the past, with this version of the board, two channels, the left and right channels always seem to be out of phase, so you have to keep that in mind. But in this case here, they corrected the problem. It is in phase. And also with this guy here, you know, you basically have to connect positive and negative on the left, and then positive and negative on the right to be left as negative and then right as positive. Hopefully that makes sense. So this is only one channel or mono output here. Other than that, there's some other small things that make this really work. I really had to almost shorten down these standoffs to make everything fit, because there's obviously going to be some really tight clearance issues with the self-enclosures with these PVC pipes. Another thing too is, I had to really shorten the leads on this, and those, I had to clip the leads off, because even though it was only maybe 3 millimeters height, it certainly made a difference in terms of getting everything to fit, because we may have an issue, we had a little bit of an issue with hitting the bottom of the subwoofer here with the battery holders there. So everything fits right now. It's perfect. Just some things, those things to keep in mind. Obviously, you know, these are slightly clocked. They're not completely vertical, simply because the biggest issue with these, at least my design here, is to get everything closed. There were clearance issues with the heat sinks, so they had to be clocked inwards. But the biggest thing was, I don't know if you can see, but I don't have these Molex connectors anymore. So those are really sticking out past in height, past the heat sink, and they were definitely interfering with the white PVC piping. So I basically removed the Molex connectors and soldered everything directly to the board. And you can see the same thing over here with this guy here. This is the 100 watt board. So this is it. I'm going to, let's see if there's anything else notable about this guy here, but I'm gonna play about 10, 11, 12 minutes of music, let you guys evaluate it, and this is gonna be the first time recording on my new iPhone XS. Supposedly it has a better mic setup than my past phone. And anyway, some other comments. This guy is really, it's probably one of my favorite builds, because the 1200 is a really good size case, not too heavy. It's literally the size of a lunchbox. You know, pretty small, actually. I don't know how much weighs now, but I'm gonna say about maybe about 8 pounds, 7 or 8 pounds. Pretty well balanced overall. And obviously the heaviest thing is the subwoofer. So I wanted to have everything kind of low, low center of gravity and even keeled. Obviously the sound, it's pretty good. I really like it. Obviously the big guy here, the 1430, is probably the best sounding one, simply because it has you know, a two-way system here, separate enclosures, just like this guy here. This one has really good definition overall, but this guy here is pretty good too. I think the parts cost is in the 250 range for everything, roughly. Yeah, that's somewhere between 200, maybe 250 or closer to 300. I haven't added everything up. I just collected parts over the past year and everything. I bought some things on sale. There's also a 3.5-inch jack in the front for wired people. I like to go wired, but I like to go Bluetooth. And it gets really gutsy. So on with the next three tunes. Thanks again for watching. And my next, just as a teaser, my next one is going to be based off of 1510 Pelican Bluetooth. It'll be, you know, do-it-yourself Bluetooth boombox featuring a 10-inch subwoofer on that one, and four mid-ranges and two AMT tweeters. But I'll make a short video on that one. But stay tuned. Thanks a lot for watching. Sorry again for not posting anything in quite some time. Been super busy. Probably one of the busiest years for my real full-time job. This is just a hobby. Hope you guys are having some good success with their own builds, and thanks again for watching. Volume.